when you engage in a practice initially, like you're doing a prayer practice, your frontal lobes typically turn on first because you're concentrating on the practice, you're focusing on the prayer, on your breath, whatever it is that you're focusing on. But that as time goes on, you begin to, if you get to a state where you have a decrease of activity in that frontal lobe, then you suddenly your purposefulness, your willfulness seems to go away, and it feels like it's kind of happening to you, it's coming to you. And so, we tend to see those kinds of experiences, flow experiences, and so forth, that are associated with that decrease of activity. But ultimately, and maybe this is the final answer to your question, I think there's an entire network of structures in the brain that become involved in these spiritual experiences. How you engage that network can be different depending on what you're doing. And if you're doing what arguably is a kind of top-down experience, then maybe you're concentrating, so you're using your frontal lobes, and then eventually it kind of changes your emotional centers, ultimately your autonomic nervous system, which regulates your body's arousal and calming centers, systems of the body. So it kind of starts up in the brain and kind of works its way down. Different rituals and certainly sexual stimulation is what we see in like orgasmic meditation, are probably a little bit more of a bottom up, or at least some combination of the two. Because like with orgasmic meditation, the interesting element there is that there is a lot of sort of cognitive things that are going on as part of the interaction that you have between the two individuals engaged in the practice. But there's also the bottom up aspect of the sexual stimulation that provides the, quote, the energy for the practice. And so when we do the brain scans, and we can talk a little bit more about that, but we see a kind of more true hybrid of both, what's coming from the bodily experiences up into the higher parts of the brain, as well as what's going on in the brain itself. But again, there are all different ways in which this whole network of structures seems to be activated or involved. And it depends on the practice, it depends on the tradition, and it depends on the outcome of the experiences.
Thank you.